I think we can do better than that. Let's let everyone know we're excited for Independent Soccer in Matthews. Fans, are you ready? We are silent. Fans, enjoy the game. sponsor of the USL. For more information, check out NikeSoccer.com. Independence corner kick taken by number 10, Jorge Herrera. Don't forget to join the Junior Jack Kids Program this season, open to ages 12 and under. Members get access to exclusive team events, prizes, and exciting promotions the entire 2017 season. For more information, visit SouthernIndependence.com. Thank you. fan of the USL on Facebook. There you'll find exclusive news and interactive content. So check out the USL on Facebook.
Thank you.
Knocker fans, if you're enjoying your new home here in Matthews, we want you to join us for the rest of the season. Ticket packages are available now. Don't forget to follow at USL on Twitter. There you can keep up with all the live action during the entire 2017 season. That's at USL on Twitter. Thank you.
Don't forget, we have multiple food trucks and beverage depots throughout the sportsplex. But be sure to stop by and try some snacks and refreshments.
Pouting now because he didn't. Thank you.
your way over to the clubhouse. Representatives of the groups and universities in another halftime, please begin to make your way over to the clubhouse. Coaches and families are coming out to enjoy tonight's game. If you're a member of Y Guys, stand up and give us a wave. We thank you for coming out tonight. Fans, if you have a group you'd like to bring out to an Independence game, visit the guest relations stand located next to our merchandise tent. There you can learn more about discounted group pricing. Once again, a big thanks to Y Guys, player, coaches, and families. We're coming out to enjoy the Independence tonight. We'd like to thank the following sponsors for their support of the Charlotte Independence, including Novant Health, Adidas, Coca-Cola, Taki, Tico Coconut Water. Harris Teeter, Toshiba Business Solutions, Courtyard Marriott, Libretto's Pizzeria, Dick's Sporting Goods, No Doubt Brewing, Old Mecklenburg Brewery, Sycamore Brewing, True Motion Therapy, Wells Fargo, and Skyview Dentistry. Thank you for your support of your Charlotte Independence. Thank you. forget, coming up at halftime, we'll have a celebration of soccer heritage, as well as a special commemoration of the 1981 Carolina Lightning Championship team. So be sure to stick around during halftime. Fans, keep up to date with the USL all season long by visiting uslsoccer.com. There you'll find everything you need to know about the USL and all of its 30 teams. uslsoccer.com. Fans, the fourth official has just announced that the minimum of 1 minute of stoppage time. A minimum of 1 minute of stoppage time. That's the end of the first half. Your halftime score, your Charlotte Independence 1, your Charlotte Independence 0. Fans, halftime is a great time to visit our merchandise tent located near the front gate for our official Independence team gear. We have those special merchandise tent. So stop by the merchandise tent. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please draw your attention to the 18-yard line closest to the clubhouse? We ask that you please hold your applause until all the following organizations have been recognized. The Shiloh Independents are launching a seasonal campaign, Celebration of Shiloh, between now and the remainder of the year. We're going to look back at Shiloh, Dr. Heritage, celebrating what clubs and organizations are doing today. What the future of soccer could look like right here in Charlotte. At this time, Jim McFarland, manager partner, Spellman, COO of the Charlotte Independents, would like to present a token of appreciation on behalf of all our fans and the entire players, staff, and organization. The Charlotte Soccer Ball is Jim Carson's director of as well as Mayor Jim Taylor of the town of Matthews. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jim Gardner, Director of Parks and Recreation, and Mayor Jim Taylor of the town of Matthews. Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to recognize the following organizations that have made commitment to the game of soccer using their time, energy, and love building grassroots programs in our communities to advance the quality of soccer in Charlotte. Again, please hold your applause until all organizations have been recognized. Here representing Carolina Rapids Soccer Club, Thomas Finley. Discovery Soccer Club, Danny Parker.
Hey, how are you?
FCB Akula, Paul Kasasa. ISL FC, Jordan Hughes. ISL Football, Alex Eifert. Gaston United Soccer Club, Jonas Richardson. Lake Norman Soccer Club, Steven Chikonis. Mid-Hill Athletic Association, Keenan Harward. South Irondale Soccer Association, Bill Wilkinson. Winthrop University, Jonathan Bradford. Winthrop University, Daniel Rittenauer. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Charlotte Independents, players, staff, and fans, please give these organizations a round of applause for all they do to raise the game in Charlotte. Ladies and gentlemen, in 1981, the unthinkable happened. On September 18th, 1981, in front of a capacity crowd of more than 20,000 soccer fans, at the Charlotte American Legion Memorial Stadium, this team, the Carolina Lightning, in their inaugural season reached the American Soccer League Championship game against New York United, who boasted the league's best record of 19 wins, 5 losses, and 4 draws. United took the lead in the second half, scoring in the 60th minute. Within minutes, the Carolina Lightning scored to tie the game. In overtime, Hugh O'Neill headed a goal to take the lead. The stalwart defense of the Lightning held off a late and furious rally to win the game. Fans jumped the rock wall and poured onto the field to celebrate with the players and the rest of Charlotte. Tonight's lead, the Charlotte Independent Clubs and Organizations recognize the legacy, but more importantly, the season's two players with a sport we all love. The fans, please hold your applause until all the following are recognized. The following are staff, players, and family members of the Carolina Lightning. Representing Tony Suarez is his sister, Anna Fleming. Tony wore number 18, was a forward, named ASL Rookie of the Year, was ASL All-Star selection and MVP of the All-Star match. He played soccer at Appalachian State and Belmont Magnet, and works for NASCAR Productions. His brother Carlos Sr. owns the Suarez Bakery off Park Road. Ladies and gentlemen, number 18, Tony Suarez. Bill's currently the executive director of the Charlotte United Football Club. He was an All-NAIA player with Erskine College before transferring to play for Clemson. Bill played goalkeeper for the Carolina Lightning. Ladies and gentlemen, Bill Finneycroft. Next up, David Pierce. Number 15, David Pierce was a defender and played at Belmont Abbey, described by Rodney Marsh as a destroyer, often marking the opposing team's best offensive player. Ladies and gentlemen, number 15, David Pierce. Next up, David Scott. David Scott was the beat reporter for the Charlotte Observer that year in covered soccer. David also played in coach soccer. His brother, Steve Scott, number 14, a forward, was described as the fittest player with speed and quickness. Steve played at UNC Chapel Hill. Number 14, Steve Scott. Next up, John McGillicuddy. John was a player and managed the ticket program, as well as the local media director for the Carolina Lightning, before internet was invented. Ladies and gentlemen, John McGillicuddy. Next up, number 20, Rick Marvin. Rick, a national defender, captain at UNC Chapel Hill, who played on the U.S. national youth team. Ladies and gentlemen, number 20, Rick Marvin. And folks, an honorable mention. In 1983, the Lightning died Bobby Moore as an assistant coach. Bobby Moore was the captain of the English national soccer team that won the World Cup in 1966. And he was awarded the Order of the British Empire in 1967. Pele once called him the best defender he'd ever played against. At age 17, Bobby Moore played for West Ham, going on to become the youngest captain of the English national team at age 22. One of the world's greatest to ever play the game, ladies and gentlemen, Bobby Moore. Next up, we have Ed Young, the first full-time employee of the Carolina Lightning, and served as the assistant general manager. Ed was also instrumental in organizing the first ever professional game played at Charlotte between the Atlanta Chiefs and Minnesota Kicks in 1979. Ed played soccer at Western Carolina University and has been a beacon for the sport and continues to champion it today. On behalf of Charlotte Independence, Jim McFilmy, managing partner and COO Michael Dierlich, we'd like to present Ed and the Lightning with this commemorative Charlotte Independence number 81 jersey. Ladies and gentlemen, please join in a round of applause for the Carolina Lightning, all the clubs and organizations, the Town of Matthews, the Mecklenburg County Parks and Recreation, and we extend a thank you. And please pay attention to the video board as we have a brief walk back to 1981, and then we'll resume our USL match. And fans, we'd like to give a special welcome to the two finalists in the recently completed first annual African Nations Cup in Charlotte, North Carolina. The finalists are Cameroon and Ghana. Congratulations. How about a round of applause for our two finalists at the first annual African Nations Cup, Cameroon and Ghana. Congratulations. Fans, if you haven't already, please follow us on Twitter and Instagram at CLT Independence and use the hashtag WeAreCLT and CLTVHAR. And fans, your attention please, the Charlotte Independence and the USL request you refrain from tossing any objects onto the field. Please use the proper concourses and refrain from climbing over seats and barriers. Any spectator entering the field or interrupting play in any manner shall be ejected and subject to arrest. Please be aware there are balls as you fly into the stands, and please remember smoking is not permitted. Independence and USL, thank you for your cooperation. Fans, the second half is about to begin. Please begin to make your way back to the field to cheer on the Independence. Fans, we're getting ready for the second half. Make some noise, let's hear ya! We are Charlotte! Thank you.
That's Broad Smoke. Broad Smoke. Your keys open, by the way.
I'd like to extend a happy 12th birthday to Austin Haney. Happy birthday, Austin. Thanks for spending your birthday with the Independents. Paying of the USL on Facebook, and you'll get exclusive Green Bay interactive content.
Thank you. Hip, hip, Jorge.
Novant Health, the official healthcare provider of your Charlotte Independence. Should you need any medical attention during tonight's game, please visit the purple Novant Health tent located field level on the north side of the stadium. Novant Health, improving the health of our community, one person at a time.
Thank you.
information, check out NikeSoccer.com.
Thank you.
Fans, tonight's attendance, a sellout crowd of 2,648 happy fans. Thank you for your support. Islanders substitution in the 64th minute. Entering the game, number 13, Mike Olaf. Exiting number 14, Danny DePrima. And stay up to date with the latest USL news and information from around the league. Tune in to USL Coast to Coast with Mike Watts, Mondays at 9 p.m. Eastern on SiriusXM FC Channel 85. Don't forget SiriusXM FC will air the USL Game of the Week. Check out USL Soccer.com for games and times. Kids, join the Junior Jets Kids program this season, open to ages 12 and under. Members get access to exclusive team events, prizes, and exciting promotions. For more information, please visit SouthernIndependence.com/JuniorJets. Coca-Cola, the official drink, excuse me, the official soft drink of your Charlotte Independence. Coca-Cola. Experience the world of follow @USL on Twitter to keep up with all the live action during the entire 2017 USL season. That's @USL on Twitter. Fans, don't forget, following tonight's game, we're going to have a fireworks display.
Okay.
Thank you.
yellow card issued against the Islanders in the 74th minute by number 15, Lee Mishonian. Yellow card, 74th minute against the Islanders, number 15, Mishonian. Novon Health is proud to be the presenting sponsor and official team physician of your Charlotte Independence. Novon Health, improving the health of our community one person at a time. Captain substitution in the 76th minute, entering the game, number 14, Louis Pilkey, exiting number 7, a big hand for Jan Ekstra. Fans, if you're looking for a cool way to beat the summer heat, be sure to sign up for Independence Youth Soccer Summer Camp, coached by the pros. Soccer camps and goalkeeper camps start soon, so visit charlotteindependence.com for more information.